Hello everyone and welcome to another video. Finally, it's that time of year. It's the top 10 winter fragrances of 2018, the designer side. I'm really excited to actually go through and do this video just because, man, this year has been a long year and it's finally time to break out those cold fragrances and just really enjoy the time, you know, as you know, we go about, you know, and do our own thing. Absolutely fantastic. So a couple of quick notes. The first note is this list is my list. It's tailored for me. These are the fragrances that I'm gonna go ahead and wear. So there's no right or wrong, but I'm always interested in the fragrances that you have. So again, leave the comments down below once you know you're finished watching this video or at any time whatsoever. So the second thing is, what do I consider a winter fragrance? Winter fragrances for me are fragrances that usually are pretty strong. They're on the strong side. You want a fragrance that's gonna go pretty well with the cold weather. It's gonna project really well. You want something that's gonna be heavy enough so that, you know, even with all of your clothes and everything like that, it's still gonna project and come outside and people are still gonna smell you. So you generally want something strong, good in the cold weather, and usually that has a good amount of longevity as well too. But you know, you can kind of bounce it around with that. So without any further ado, let's just go ahead and get started. Now the 10th fragrance is generally a fragrance that I use around the office, and I've been wearing this one in the cold weather more and it's been doing really good. So I'm gonna keep wearing it in the winter, and that is Prada's Amber Bore Homme. Oh man, this one, fantastic fragrance that just does really well again for the office. I spray it on, it's got this soft smell, it's kind of got this almost baby powderish type of a feel to it. Smell really good, feel really confident with it, and that's what it's essentially accomplishing. So fantastic fragrance for that. Prada Amber Bore Homme. Now the 9th fragrance on the list is from the house of Jean-Paul Gaultier. The fragrance that we're talking about is called Le Male Intense or Le Male Ultra. Fantastic flanker for the house. This is one that I like to wear specifically outside when I'm out doing something casual. This is gonna last most of the day, if not all of the day. It, you know, retains its strength. It's got a sweet kind of smell to it that is really playful. So generally it gets a good amount of compliments with it as well too. Fantastic fragrance, underrated just because there's so many freaking flankers from the house of Jean-Paul Gaultier. But that aside, still a great deal and something that you want to take a look at. Now the 8th fragrance on the list is a fragrance that I like to wear when I don't want something too heavy, and that is Dior's Fahrenheit Aqua. Fahrenheit Aqua, not the original Fahrenheit. And that is because Fahrenheit Aqua has more of a playful feel to it, has more of a light feel to it. And while I'm in the winter and most of the fragrances that I wear fit the description, they're heavy fragrances and everything, sometimes I like to go a little bit light, switch it up a little bit. Maybe I'm gonna be in all day, I won't be outside, things like that. I'll choose to wear this one. It's a pretty versatile fragrance in that regards. It's, you know, lighter on that petroleum feel. It still has that revolutionary Aqua Fahrenheit or the Fahrenheit kind of feel, but it's its own fragrance. So yeah, fantastic one, Aqua Fahrenheit. Number 7 is from the house of Christian Dior. The fragrance we're talking about is Dior Homme. Dior Homme is another one that I like to wear specifically when it's cold. I mean, obviously these are all when it's colder out, but this one specifically I like to wear when I'm dressed up a little bit and I'm going out specifically with a suit and without my traditional like jacket or leather jacket, things like that. I like to throw this one on. Now, I used to wear this one specifically when it was casual, but I've been switching it up and it's been doing great in other scenarios, you know, where you're more dressed up like that as well too. It's been getting a good amount of compliments, and you know, this year I'm expecting it to kind of do the same, as I've got a lot of engagements where I'm gonna be dressed up and I'm gonna be going out and, you know, be mingling with people, and this does really well in those scenarios, right? So Dior Homme at number 7. Now number 6 is from the house of Dolce & Gabbana. We're talking about the one, the EDP version, the Eau de Parfum version. The reason why I like this one a lot is it's my ultimate, consummate, casual fragrance. This is the type of fragrance that I throw on just every day. I don't really have any plans. I'm gonna toss on the one and it's gonna do fantastic. It does really well in almost every respect. It's more the fragrance for me. This is really replacing, if those of you who have been following me for a while know that I really like Express Reserve. This reminds me of Express Reserve in many ways, and it kind of wears the same to me. So I like to wear this one out to a bar, like to wear this one out if I'm going drinking, if I'm going just chilling, lounging with friends, my wife, then this is the one that I go ahead and put on. So the one from Dolce & Gabbana. Now, number five is another work fragrance that I have. I've been leaning on this one as well, specifically when I have big meetings and meetings that I don't wanna, I guess you could say, offend anyone. We're talking about Dior's Sauvage. This is the EDP or the Eau de Parfum version of Sauvage. Now, I really do like to wear this one because it does get compliments, but in the office, you don't really give compliments that much. And so what I'm really relying on when I go out for this fragrance is that people are gonna smell me, I'm gonna smell good, and at the same time, it's gonna somehow positively influence whatever it is that I'm either pitching, whatever it is that, you know, I'm discussing about, or, you know, trying to get some buy-in from some stakeholders, you name it. That's kind of when I like to wear this one. A little bit superstitious on me, I'm not quite sure if it actually works, but it's just something that I like to do. So Dior's Sauvage EDP. Now, the fourth fragrance on the list is a replacement for another fragrance that's there. We're looking at Valentino Uomo Intense. This one smells a lot like Dior Homme Intense. Now, I mention that because Dior Homme Intense is not actually on this list, and it usually is, but this one has been giving a little bit of a different edge to it for me, and this is a prototypical one that I like to wear when it's casual, it's really cold out, but at the same time, I know I'm gonna have to wear like a heavy leather jacket or a heavy, you know, winter coat, and, you know, I'm still gonna be outside for most of the time, you know, doing whatever I need to do, interacting with people, and then I'm gonna go inside to a bar or something of those lines and socialize. That's where I like to wear this one. So fantastic one around, last all, you know, the entire night, easily, no problems whatsoever. You wake up, you're gonna smell like this as well too. Fantastic fragrance all around, Valentino Uomo Intense. Now, number three is actually a replacement for another fragrance, not on this list. It is Club de Nuit Intense Man. This one is the replacement for Aventus. My Aventus stock is running low, and I've got a pretty good stock of Aventus. It's a great smelling scent that I have, and I think I'm at like maybe 30% or 35% left of Aventus. So I've just been, you know, wearing that one out. And this one, while it doesn't exactly smell like it, it's really freaking close to it. And I really do like the scent of it. So it's gonna kind of act as its replacement. Any scenario you can kind of think of is one that you can wear Club de Nuit in, and it does an absolutely fantastic job. Now, the second fragrance on the list is a blast from the past. We're looking at Angel Men. Yes, this is in the original metal cask here. And, this one. Actually, you even have, it's starting to rust on the bottom of it just because I keep it in a cool place with the condensation sometimes. I'm getting off track. But anyways, this one, again, is another fragrance that I like to wear when I have to do things outside and inside at the same time. Generally speaking, you know, I can wear it casually, and I have been actually known to just go for broke and wear this one to work. I would not recommend people wearing it to work, but it's just something that for some strange reason I like to do. So it's a classic, it's excellent fragrance. Check it out, Angel Men, if you haven't already. And the number one fragrance for winter on the designer side for me should come as no surprise to most of you if you haven't heard it being called out just yet. La Nuit de l'Homme from the house of Yves Saint Laurent. Now, unfortunately for those of you, sorry, I think it has been reformulated to the point where it's not the same potent, magnificent beast that it once was, but I've still got the original, and I love this one so much. And I generally choose to wear this one on date nights. I like to wear it on special nights, kind of going out at this point now. And sometimes I'll wear it casually as well too. Generally pretty dressed up with it. It is a magnificent fragrance. It's one of the best releases for fragrances as far as I'm concerned. So that's pretty much it, guys. Let me know what fragrances you guys are wearing for the winter of 2018 here. Designer side, I'm always curious to see what you guys are wearing, just to see, you know, kind of the trade winds, if you will, of what people are actually going through and wearing. All right? So that's pretty much it. Thank you, guys. Take care of yourselves, and you guys have a great day.